Hey y'all, I'm hella late with this, but I just wanted to come give you a quick analysis of Glover Teixeira versus Thiago Santos. I should say Santos versus Teixeira. This was the last fight night from Saturday, November 7th at the UFC Apex in Las Vegas. Earlier, kind of interesting move because I'm a striker first before I was ever a grappler. The Georgian Giga Chikadze versus the newcomer Jamie Simmons. He finishes him by setting up a high kick with a mid kick. It's kind of a basic move, but you have to defend somewhere. You have to defend either low, mid, or high. He hits him with a mid kick right about here, which is going to knock the stamina of Simmons out a little bit. So now Simmons is very wary of getting hit there again, because if he keeps getting hit there, it'll drain him out. For those of you who are Texas Hold'em or poker players, it's the idea of blinding somebody out. You know, steadily, if you make big bets in poker and you have more money than someone else, you know, the luck of the draw is likely not going to get to them. And you can make somebody lose with timidity, with not committing. Someone who's non-committal will easily get blinded out in poker. And if you're non-committal to getting struck in a midsection, your stamina will slowly drain and you will lose the fight either on points or through a body kick TKO, or KO, which are some of my favorite. So he defends it the next time, in which case Giga comes in and head kicks him. TKO, KO, whatever you want to call it. You know, the ref intervenes, so it's TKO. I know some people use the word KO kind of loosely. There was a heavyweight fight with Andre Arlovsky. He slugged it out with a decision win over Tanner Boser. It's incredible. He's still in his 40s, but let's get to the main event. Another gentleman who's in his 40s, who I really like. So the fight between Santos and Teixeira really illustrated something that I really don't like about MMA, how it is now. And it is basically a degradation of the Vale Tudo, or the NHB, the no holds barred edition section area. We're seeing the proliferation of various so-called bare knuckle boxing promotions. They still have wraps, so in my opinion, it's not bare knuckle, it's just no glove. And the Leth Way, which is the Burmese or Myanmar version of Thai boxing, which some argue may have preceded it, again, they also still wrap it up, but they call it bare knuckle kind of Muay Thai, or bare knuckle striking plus headbutts. So the original no holds barred NHB Vale Tudo Leis, you had no gloves, no wraps, and sometimes no rounds or unlimited rounds, depending on the promotion. Especially early in like the 20s in Brazil, some of those Vale Tudo matches were like 3 hours long. And I understand people don't have the attention span. There's always this balance between simulating a fight and it not being a fight. It is a sport. It is a game. It is a simulation at the end of the day. But I think we should try to simulate the fight as much as possible and not build these ideas of false machismo. You know, everyone thinks it's the fists which are the greatest things. But if Thiago Santos did not have his gloves, did not have his wraps, the way he fights, which is constantly moving forward, constantly punching, constantly striking. And there were several episodes where he dropped Glover Teixeira, but Glover's chin was just too strong. He would have broken his hand a lot sooner. And what we saw even in this were the rounds saving Thiago Santos's life. Several times you see at the end of the round, Glover Teixeira is on top of Thiago Santos, and Thiago Santos is just surviving. He doesn't even know how to escape the position. And you could tell me he's just playing the game with the rule set as it is, and that's fair. But I'm just dreaming of something better. I'm dreaming of something where, at the bare minimum, if you keep rounds, allow Glover to be in the same position or as close to the same position as possible as where they left off at the end of the last round, or abolish rounds outright and see where the fight goes, see how it progresses. If they go to a standstill, then you could allow the referee to intervene and stand up. But frankly, I think referees intervene way too much in the first place. So anyway, you see Thiago Santos bust his load way too early. As I said, he's really going like his hardest. He's someone who moved up from middleweight, by the way. Remember, middleweight's 185 pounds, but a lot of those guys weigh between 200 and 210. So making 205 is no problem. He might have even gained a little weight or stayed what he was. 205, 206 is the limit for non-title fights at light heavyweight, and 205 is kind of the normal title weight limit. But these guys regularly come in above that. He's probably 210. He might even be 215 or 220. Who knows? I know Corey Anderson used to walk around at 230 when he fought at light heavyweight, and now he's doing great over there at Bellator, no longer in the UFC. But Thiago Santos is going his hardest trying to defeat Glover Teixeira on his feet, and he's doing really well. In fact, he's outstriking him. And you see a lot of jiu-jitsu guys failing in the UFC, one, because of gloves, two, because of wraps, three, because of rounds, but four, because the big thing about a lot of jiu-jitsu gyms is when you practice, there's this unwritten rule that you're encouraged to engage the adversary or opponent or training partner within the rounds and the rules of submission grappling. In a UFC fight, in an MMA fight as it is now, someone like Thiago Santos, who does not want to engage you, will defeat many people who do not have standing grappling skills. What made Glover Teixeira different is that from the standing position, not only did he have phenomenal ground submission grappling, but from the standing position, some people call it wrestling, I'll just call it standing grappling, he knew how to take hits, but ultimately get the clinch, and then from the clinch, either single leg or double leg takedown. From the takedown, he knows how to get on top, and once he's on top, it's over. The fight ended with Thiago Santos' stamina depleted from trying to finish Glover Teixeira, and he couldn't, and he basically gave up before he gave up. He turned his back to an expert submission grappler. And that wasn't so that he can get wailed on, but he did get wailed on a little bit. It's so that the Mata Leão, as they say in Portuguese, the lion killer, or the rear naked choke, or the rear naked strangle, could be locked in and submitted. But if you saw, he had that strangle or choke or that lion killer, that Mata Leão, for barely a few seconds. Really, his stamina was shot. He had seen Glover Teixeira on top of him for a few rounds already, and he did not see a way in which he could escape the top pressure. So he gave him his back to say, I give up, in the you could say prideful way, or in the most respectful, honorable way, to go out on his shield. And then he let him sink the choke in without any real resistance. And after a few seconds, he tapped out. He was submitted. It was all love between the Brazilians after the fact. Shout out to Glover Teixeira. I hope that he gets a shot either at the Polish man, Jan Błachowicz, who has the title now, or Israel Adesanya, who's going to be challenging him soon enough. So it would be interesting if Izzy beat Jan and then defended against Glover, because then you'd see Izzy against a striker and against submission grappler, a top tier in a weight division above him. And if he did that, he would really be cementing his status as top five, dead or alive, and potentially even the GOAT. I know there's a lot of talks about GOATs nowadays, but look forward to seeing whoever Glover fights next. And I hope he retires soon. I hope he gets a shot at the title, and I hope he retires soon, because he is phenomenal. And he's not just a gatekeeper. Look at him getting rid of top competition. Thiago Santos just fought a very controversial fight with John Jones, who a lot of people say is the GOAT. So the fact that a lot of the commentary or the chattering classes already mentioned that Glover has now finished two guys that John Jones was incapable of or did not want to submit. So shout out to Glover and shout out to Jiu-Jitsu.